authentic living begins with realizing deeply in our heart this pain of leading a mediocre life. And when we stay with this pain, do not run away from it, then there is a creative beginning in our life. In that very moment, when we stay with the fact of mediocrity, the fact of lack of authenticity, staying with the fact brings some kind of transformation. But when we stay with the fact, howsoever painful it may be, howsoever disturbing it may be, if we don't escape from it, then there is a natural transformation happening in that fact. When we are listening deeply, without depending on our past baggage, being aware of this fact that as long as the conditioned me comes in the way with all its interpretation, prejudices, likes and dislikes, then listening is not happening. I'm only reacting from my past background. So I feel this authentic life, authentic living begins with this authentic listening. Listening from a deep ground of heart, listening from all our senses, listening from a deep stillness of being. Then that listening itself a creative process, and that listening brings authenticity. So we can be aware in the process of listening, how we are listening. If listening is not happening, can we stay with the fact of non-listening? I watch this fact that my mind is chattering, busy, moving here and there. Then simply being aware of this fact, gently, affectionately, without any judgment, then staying with the fact of non-listening brings the quality of listening. Similarly, how I observe? Am I observing or am I reacting from my past background, from my past memories? And when I notice it, I realize that I am not observing. I am only reacting from the past conditioning, and that is not observation. So can I stay with this fact of non-observation? It's not happening in this moment. I become intensely aware of this reality, and that is the beginning of pure observation. That is authentic observation, authentic seeing. So can I watch myself? Can I listen to myself from that deep ground of silence, from the deep ground of love? Then I am not judging myself. I am not watching myself, listening to myself through the past stories. These stories may be created by me or the others or by society. So I don't depend on any story to connect with myself. Then I meet myself from an authentic ground. If I am able to do this with myself, meeting myself completely from one's whole being, then I can also meet other human beings from this beautiful ground. Then I am not meeting others from limited categories, definitions, from the stories, then there is a real deep relationship which is authentic. So this authentic life begins with this choiceless, deep listening and observation. So I learned this art of authentic living by learning this art of authentic listening, authentic observation, this deep sensitivity, humility, sense of deep beauty, love and compassion. And this is living from a totally different dimension, a dimension which is deeply creative, authentic. And from this dimension, of course, I can use thought, knowledge in a beautiful manner, in a more creative manner. Then thought and knowledge will not become destructive, bringing disharmony, disorder, suffering in our life. And I feel we must ask this question: can we live without any suffering, without any conflict? Without any hatred towards anybody? Then we are really respecting this beautiful earth. We are honoring this beautiful gift of life. Then we are not the only creature who are destructive on this earth, who have become a threat to other creatures on this earth. So it's a great responsibility, a sacred responsibility, to be awake. Awake now, not wait. And without this awakening, we cannot live peacefully, happily, joyfully. So we must ask this question, perhaps when we wake up in the morning: what is the state of my mind and heart? Can I watch it? Can I listen to it? Can I feel this deep connection with the whole earth, with all consciousness, with the whole universe? So can I be aware of this fact when I begin the day? Just being aware of my first thoughts, first feelings, first emotions, watching them very gently, affectionately. And watching the mind, if it is beginning by creating some problem. Life is not a problem to be solved every day, every hour. And mind is good at creating problems and then trying to solve it so that it remains occupied. Of course, there can be some factual problems, real problems, and we can meet those problems with this intelligence of deep listening and observation, the intelligence of stillness, the intelligence of love. With that we can solve any problems. But this intelligence will also help me, guide me, not to create problems artificially, out of nothing. Then my mind, my being is learning to live without problems, learning to live with a sense of emptiness. If nothing is happening, then my mind is not restless, because it is always seeking something to happen. So when I am waking up, can I watch if there is a song in my heart? Or my heart, my mind is complaining again, oh, another heavy day is beginning. Just watch it. And there may not be any heaviness. Heaviness is created by my thought. When there is no awareness, when I'm not listening, when I'm not observing. and let go of all heaviness created by thought, by mind, and begin the day with sense of lightness, sense of joy in the heart, and feeling this gratitude. Wow, this is another day of a great gift. Can I begin this day with wonder, with innocence, with love, with simplicity? And then I meet whatever challenges are there during the day in my work, in my profession, from a quiet space, from a non-reactive space. Then I am bringing more peace in my relationship, wherever I am. And during this living, during the day, can I ask, are there some moments, even few minutes, when I really listen to my friend, my colleague, my partner, fully listen without any expectation, without any motive. Did I see something new? Did I watch a face of another human being really completely, as if for the first time? Because usually we are not watching. We are just seeing the picture which I already have in my mind. But if I am aware of this habitual pattern, then it can be silent and there can be a new watching, a new listening. And similarly, when I end the day, is it possible to end the day without accumulating problems inside? Okay, I have done my best during the day. I attended things. There are things which are remain, which need to be attended next day, but I'm not carrying all this burden and going to sleep with it. Just finishing the day without any sense of regret or complaint, I can go through the day, and if I like, I can also write a diary. These are the things I learned today. These are the things I missed. Just going through the day like you go through a movie, but without any judgment. And I go very slowly into this deep rest, into the sleep, with the quality of this awareness, letting the mind, the heart, the senses calm, peaceful, and feeling this deep gratitude that life gave me this opportunity to live this day. And I lived it with whatever intelligence, creativity I have. And I am thankful to the whole universe. If there were some conflicts, you just let it go, forgive. If there were some hurts, can we let it go? And don't accumulate anything. So that next day we are really fresh, when we are waking up with this quality of stillness, attention, the quality of love in the heart.